Dead space refers to the volume of ventilated air that does not participate in gas exchange. Tidal volume is the volume of air that is inhaled and exhaled from the lungs during normal breathing. By comparing the two, you get the dead space to tidal volume ratio, which is used to measure the efficiency of gas exchange. In other words, it's a ratio that shows the percentage of each breath that does not participate in the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide. So now let's talk about how to calculate dead space. And it can be calculated using the Bohr equation, which is given as a ratio of dead space to tidal volume. In other words, the dead space to tidal volume ratio is equal to PaCO2 minus PeCO2 divided by PaCO2, which PaCO2 stands for the partial pressure of arterial carbon dioxide, and PeCO2 represents exhaled or end-tidal carbon dioxide. And you may have heard the equation pronounced PaCO minus PeCO over PaCO, which is just an easier way to remember it. Now let's do an example. Let's say an adult patient has a PaCO2 of 42 and a PeCO2 of 33. What is the dead space to tidal volume ratio? Well, all you have to do is plug the numbers into the formula that we just discussed, which would look like this. 42 minus 33 divided by 42. And if you do the calculation, the dead space to tidal volume ratio for this patient is 0.21 or 21%. In general, the dead space to tidal volume ratio is typically increased in patients with conditions that cause increased physiologic dead space. Some examples include CHF, pulmonary embolism, ARDS, pulmonary hypertension, and patients who are receiving mechanical ventilation. The dead space to tidal volume ratio is also increased when a patient has a decreased tidal volume, such as during rapid, shallow breathing. This ratio is also helpful during ventilator weaning to determine if a patient is ready for extubation. In general, the dead space to tidal volume ratio must be less than 60% to consider weaning. In other words, if this ratio is greater than 60%, the patient should continue to receive mechanical ventilatory support. And if you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.